friends, let us solve one physics paper, paper 2, multiple choice extended, 06-25-23, October-November 2020. And the first question is, a micrometer screw gauge reads 0.02 millimeter when the jaws are fully closed. It reads 0.56 millimeter when measuring the diameter of a metal wire. What is the diameter of wire? Since our initial reading is not 0, it is 0.02, we will subtract this from the final reading. So we have 0.56 minus 0.02, that comes to 0.54, and the correct option is B. 0.54 millimeter is the diameter of the wire. Second question. Object P moves at a constant speed of 5 meter per second repeatedly backwards and forwards in a straight line. Object Q moves at a constant speed of 5 meter per second vertically downwards. Object R moves at a constant speed of 5 meter per second in a circle. Which objects are moving with uniform velocity? Velocity is speed in particular direction. So for uniform velocity, only object should have constant speed, but also its direction should be same. So let us see out of the objects P, Q and R, which one has constant speed in same direction. In object P, speed is constant, but it moves backwards and forwards, so direction changes. In object Q, it moves at a constant speed vertically downward, so speed is constant and direction is also same. Object R moves at a constant speed, but direction is not same, because when object moves in a circle, direction at every point will be different. So out of the three objects, object Q has uniform velocity, and the correct answer is option B, Q only. Third question. The diagram shows a velocity time graph for an object which is accelerating. What is the acceleration of the object? We are given a graph with time in seconds on x-axis and velocity in meter per second on y-axis. To find acceleration, we have to find gradient of this graph. Gradient is equals to rise by run. Rise here is from 20 to 120 and run is from 0 to 40. So our gradient is equals to rise by run, that is 120 minus 20 by 40 minus 0, that is 100 by 40. This on calculation comes to 2.5. So correct answer here is option B. 2.5 meter per second square is the acceleration of the object. Let's do question 4. Which quantity is weight an example of? Before selecting answer, let us have look at definition of weight. In physics, weight is defined as a gravitational force acting on an object. So weight is an example of force. Answer B, force is the correct answer. Question 5. An object of mass 1 kg is at rest on Earth. An identical object is at rest on a planet with a gravitational field strength of twice that on Earth. Which row correctly compares the object on the planet to the object on the Earth? Weight is equals to m into g. Since mass will remain same, but g on planet is double that on Earth, so its weight on the planet will be double. In next column, we are asked to decide its acceleration when the same horizontal force is applied. Acceleration is equals to force by mass. Mass on both, that is Earth and planet, is same. That will remain same, 1 kg. And force applied, we are given that force applied is same. So, since force is same, mass is same, acceleration will be same. So, correct answer here is A, its weight will be double on the planet and acceleration will be equal to that on the Earth if same horizontal force is applied. Sixth question. A square wooden raft floats on a lake. The density of water in the lake is 1000 kg per meter cube. Sides of the raft are 2 meter long and thickness of the raft is 0.20 meters. Mass of the raft is 700 kg. How many barrels each of 100 kg could be placed on the raft before its surface sinks to the surface of water? We are given dimensions of the raft, so we can calculate its volume. We have mass also, so we can calculate its density. So density of the raft along with barrels should not become more than 1000 kg, which is the density of water. So if it is within 1000 kg, it will float, otherwise it will sink. Volume of raft is 2 by 2 into 0.2, which comes to 0.8 meter cube. And density of raft is mass upon volume. Mass is 700 kg. So 700 by 0.8 comes to 875 kg per meter cube, which is less than 1000 kg. If we place one barrel of 100 kg on this raft, mass will become 700 that of raft plus 100 kg that of barrel. It becomes 800. So density of raft with one barrel will be 800 divided by 0.8. So that comes to 1000 kg per meter cube approximately. This is just enough for raft to float. If we increase the number of barrels, its mass will increase, its density will increase, and it will sink. So correct answer is option A, one barrel. Let us do question 7. The diagram shows a car moving along a road. The force due to engine is 1500 Newton and the drag force is 200 Newton. What is the motion of a car? Since the two forces are unbalanced, there is resultant force, and resultant force is equal to engine force minus drag force, or 1500 Newton minus 200 Newton. That is 1300 Newton is the resultant force. And if there is resultant force, there is acceleration, which means increase in speed. So correct answer is option C, increasing speed. Question 8. The diagram shows a trolley used to transport a load of 400 Newton. A force F vertically downwards is needed to balance a trolley as shown. The center of mass of trolley is vertically above the pivot. What is the value of F? Load 400 newtons is 15 centimeter away from center of mass, and force F has to be applied, which is at 40 centimeter away from center of mass. Let us equalize it. So we have F times 40 is equals to 15 times 400. That gives us F is equals to 400 into 15 by 40. On calculation, this answer comes to 150 Newton. So the force applied should be 150 Newton. Let's move on to question 9. A ball of mass M falls vertically and hits a hard surface. Its speed on hitting the surface is V1. It rebounds vertically upwards with a speed V2. What is the change in momentum of the ball? Initial momentum P1 is minus MV1, final momentum MV2. Change in momentum P2 minus P1 is MV2 minus MV1. M is taken common, and we have M into V1 plus V2 as the change in momentum of the ball. So correct answer is option C, MV1 plus V2. Let us see what we have in 10th question. An object of mass 4.5 kg is traveling at 7 meter per second. How much kinetic energy does the object have? Mass is given, velocity is given. We will substitute these values in the formula for kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is equals to half mv square. Substituting the values, we have half into 4.5 into 7 square, which on calculation comes to 110.25. This can be rounded off to 110. So option C, 110 joules is the correct answer. Question 11. A number of ways in which we use energy are listed. In which is the ultimate source of energy not the sun? A. Energy is provided by horse to pull a cart. Energy is provided by hydroelectric generators to heat a house. Energy is provided by nuclear power station. Energy is provided by windmill to pump water to a fountain. Horse gets its energy from plants. Plants carry out photosynthesis using solar energy and prepare food. Hydroelectric energy depends on water cycle, which ultimately depends on solar energy. Windmills or wind energy can also be indirectly connected to solar energy. So in the given options, option C, energy provided by nuclear power station does not have its source in sun. So correct answer here is option C, energy provided by nuclear power station. 12th question, to calculate the power produced by a force, the size of force must be known. What else needs to be known to calculate the power? We know power is equals to work by time, but work is equals to force into distance. So we have power is equals to force into distance upon time. So three factors on which power depends are force, distance and time. Beside force, it is important to know distance that the force moves the object, time for which the force acts on the object for calculating the power. Option A is the correct answer. Both distance and time is needed to calculate the power. 13th question. A student calculates the pressure due to liquid at point X. Student takes four measurements. First, density of the liquid. Second, temperature of the liquid. Third, depth of point X below the surface of liquid. And fourth, surface area of the liquid. Which measurements must the student use in her pressure calculations? Formula to calculate pressure at point X is P is equals to H rho G. Instead of rho, I have written D here. D and rho both are same density. H is the depth of the point and G is gravitational force, which we already know. So student needs to calculate H, that is depth of the point X below the surface of liquid, and D, density of the liquid. Option B, 1 and 3 is the correct answer. The next question, that is question number 14. The diagram shows a mercury barometer. Which height is used as a measurement of atmospheric pressure? Atmospheric pressure at this point is balanced by this column of mercury, and difference between these two levels is represented by C. So height C is the measurement of atmospheric pressure. 15th question. A student splashes water on her face. Here are three statements about the effects. P, water uses energy to evaporate. This is a correct statement. Q, water gains energy from the student. Again, correct statement. R, face of the student cools. Again, a correct statement. So which statements are correct? All three are correct. Option D, P, Q and R is the correct answer. Let's do question 16. Equal volumes of solids and liquids experience different changes of volume when they are heated through same temperature range. What is the reason for this? Let these diagrams represent solid before heating and after heating, liquid before heating and after heating. We know particles in solid are more tightly packed compared to liquids. So average increase in the separation of particles in liquid is greater than the average increase in the separation of those in the solid. So option A is the correct answer here. Let's do question 17. Which physical property changes when temperature is measured with a liquid and glass thermometer? Four options given are electromotive force, pressure, resistance and volume. In liquid and glass type of thermometer, liquid in the bulb expands due to heat and rises in the capillary. So what is changing here is volume of the liquid. So correct answer here is option D, volume. Our next question, number 18. The diagram shows steam being passed into water to raise the temperature of water. Specific latent heat of steam is
2200 joules per gram. Specific heat capacity of water is 4.2 joules per gram degree Celsius. Mass of water being heated is 490 grams.
Which mass of steam must be passed into the water to raise the temperature from 19 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius? Here steam is being used to raise the temperature of water. So heat supplied by steam is equals to heat gained by water. But how much is heat supplied by steam? The formula which we will use is mass of steam into specific latent heat of steam is equals to mass of water into specific heat capacity of water into delta T, which is a rise in temperature or change in temperature.
You will observe formula used on both sides is different. On the steam side, that is left side, there is change in phase, that is steam at 100 degrees Celsius changes to water at 100 degrees Celsius. So there is change in phase and formula used will be ML. Whereas on the right hand side, there is no change in phase, only temperature changes there. So formula used is MC delta T. Let us now substitute the values and we have mass of steam which we have to find into specific latent heat of steam 2200 is equals to 490 mass of water into specific heat capacity of water 4.2 into change in temperature, is final temperature 100 minus initial temperature 19. This on calculation comes to 75.77. This can be rounded off to 76 grams. So correct answer here is option B, 76 gram. 76 gram of steam is needed to raise the temperature of water from 19 to 100 degrees Celsius. 19th question. The diagram shows the view of a room heated by a radiator. The arrow line from X to Y is the path of convection current in the air. Which row about air temperature and air density at X and Y is correct? Let us compare temperature and density at points X and Y. At point X, due to heat of radiator, temperature will be higher, so density of air will be less and it will rise up. By the time this air reaches point Y, its temperature decreases and density becomes high. So we can say at point X, temperature is high. At point Y, density is high. So correct answer is option B, temperature higher at X and density higher at Y. 20th question. A warm, dark colored surface emits radiation. It is decided to increase the amount of radiation produced. Three suggestions are made. First, make the surface hotter. Yes, that will increase the amount of radiation produced. Second, color the surface white. No, dark colors are better absorbers and better emitters. So this option is wrong. Third, increase the area of surface. Yes, increasing the area of surface will increase the amount of radiation produced. So in this case, suggestion 1 and 3 are correct one. Option C, 1 and 3 only is the correct answer. Next question, question 21. Which row correctly describes light waves? Light waves are transverse waves. So we have to choose between option C and D. And in light waves, direction of vibrations is perpendicular to the direction of wave travel. So correct answer is option D. Light waves are transverse waves and direction of vibrations is perpendicular to the direction of wave travel. Next question, number 22. A water wave has speed of 2 meter per second. Four complete waves pass a point every 10 seconds. What is the wavelength of the wave? Formula we will use to find wavelength is equals to wave speed upon frequency. We are given wave speed, that is 2 meter per second, but frequency we don't have. We have to first find frequency. Frequency is number of waves passing through a point in 1 second. We are given in 10 seconds 4 waves pass through a point. So 10 seconds 4 waves, 1 second 4 by 10 waves or 0.4 wave. That means 0.4 wave passes through a point in 1 second.
and frequency is 0.4. Let us substitute this frequency in the formula. We have wavelength is equals to 2 by 0.4, which comes to 5 meter. So correct answer here is option C, 5 meter is the wavelength of the wave. Question 23. A driver sits in a car. She has a rear view plane mirror 0.5 meter in front of her. A bus is 7.5 meter behind the driver. The driver looks at the image of bus in her mirror. How far is the image away from her? Let us first find distance between mirror and bus. Distance between mirror and driver is 0.5 meter and distance between driver and bus is 7.5 meter. So total distance between mirror and bus is 8 meter. So we can say bus is 8 meter in front of the mirror. And image of bus will be 8 meters behind the mirror. But we are asked to find distance between image of bus and driver. That is 8 meter plus 0.5 meter, which comes to 8.5 meter. Correct answer here is option D, 8.5 meter. Image is 8.5 meter away from the driver. Question 24. The diagram shows white light passing through a prism. Which description of what happens as the light passes into the prism is correct? We can see in the diagram white light enters one surface of the glass prism. It gets refracted and on second surface again it gets refracted and separated in different colors causing dispersion. We have to remember speed of red light is greater than the speed of violet light. And red light is least refracted, or compared to other colors, it is less refracted. So correct answer here is option B. Speed of red light is greater than the speed of violet light and red light is least refracted. Let's move on to next question, which is question 25. The diagram shows three types of electromagnetic radiations listed in a particular order. The electromagnetic radiation is traveling in a vacuum. Which quantities increase in magnitude going from left to right across the list? Three types of electromagnetic radiations from left to right given are microwaves, infrared and X-rays. And the quantity which increases in magnitude from left to right is frequency only. Option A is the correct answer, frequency only. Question 26. A sound wave travels through air. What name to the region in which air molecules are further apart than normal? Sound waves travel in the form of longitudinal waves comprising of compressions and rarefactions. And the name given to the region in which molecules are further apart than normal is rarefaction. The correct answer here is option C, rarefaction. It is the name given to region in which molecules are further apart than normal. Our next question, number 27. A police car with its siren sounding is stationary in heavy traffic. A pedestrian notices that although the loudness of the sound produced does not change, the pitch varies. Which note describes the amplitude and the frequency of sound? Loudness of the sound depends on amplitude and pitch depends on frequency. Here we are given that loudness of the sound produced by siren of the police car does not change. That means amplitude is constant. And it is given pitch varies. That means frequency is varying. So correct option is B. Amplitude constant, frequency varying. Let us see what we have in question 28. A piece of steel is slightly magnetized. It is hit several times with a hammer. What effect will this have on the steel? We are given two conditions. One, steel is parallel to strong magnetic field. And second one is the steel is at right angles to a weak magnetic field. Option B is the correct answer here. In parallel position, it becomes magnetized more strongly and at right angles, it loses its magnetism.
Let us move on to our next question, which is question 29. A negatively charged cloud passes over a tall steel frame building. A charge is induced on the building by the cloud because charges flow through the building. What charge is induced on the building and in which direction do the charge carriers move? Since cloud is negatively charged, positive charge will be induced in the building and it will pass from building to earth. So option A is the correct answer. Charge induced on building is positive. Direction of charge flow is from building to earth.
Our next question, that is question number 30. Electromotive force EMF is defined in terms of energy supplied in driving which physical quantity around a complete circuit? And correct answer is option A, charge. EMF is energy supplied in driving charge around complete circuit. Let us see what we have in question 31. A student uses four ammeters P, Q, R and S to measure the current in different parts of the circuit shown. Which two ammeters read the largest current? Ammeter P and Q will read current of the main circuit. Ammeters R and S will read the current in parallel branches. Total current in the circuit is sum of the currents in parallel branches. That means current shown by ammeter P or Q is equal to sum of current shown by ammeter R and S. Since current shown by ammeter P or ammeter Q is sum of the current shown by ammeter R and ammeter S, we can say ammeter P and Q read the largest current, and correct answer is option A, P and Q. Our next question, question number 32. Three statements about a relay are given. First, a relay has a coil that becomes a temporary magnet when in operation. It's a correct statement. Second statement, a large current in a relay coil is used to switch off a smaller current. It's a wrong one. In fact, a small current in a relay coil is used to switch on a larger current. And this is our third statement. So out of these three, one and three are correct and second one is wrong. So correct option is option C, one and three only. Question 33. Which combination of logic gates gives the truth table shown? According to this truth table, if we take inputs X and Y as 0, 0, output Z should be 1. So let us try taking 0, 0 in all the combination of logic gates. Wherever combination gives us output Z as 1, we will continue further and take next input, that is 0, 1. Option A, if we take inputs X and Y as 0, 0, OR gate gives output 0 and NOT gate inverts this and makes it 1. So output Z is 1. We can go ahead with this combination. Let us see what happens at B. If we take inputs X and Y as 0 and 0, AND gate will give output 0 and NOT gate will change this to 1. So output at Z is 1. So we can go ahead with this combination also. Let us try C combination. X and Y if taken 0, 0, output of this will be 1 after NAND gate and NOT gate will change it to 0. So output at Z is 0 in combination C. So this is eliminated because we need 1 at Z. Let us try D. If 0, 0 is taken for X and Y, NOR gate will give us 1 and NOT gate will change it to 0. Output at Z is 0. So this is also eliminated. Now next step we will try with A and B combinations only. Next input which we are trying is 0 at X, 1 at Y and output Z should be 1. In logic gates combination A, if we take inputs X and Y as 0, 1, OR gate gives output 1 and NOT gate changes it to 0 at Z. So this combination is also eliminated as we need output 0 to be 1. Let us try B now. If we take 0, 1 as X and Y inputs, AND gate will give us output 0 and NOT will change it to 1 at Z, which is what we wanted. So truth table given in the question is that of logic gate combination at B. Correct answer is B. Let's move on to next question, that is question 34. Graph X shows output from an AC generator. Which changes can be made so that the generator produces graph Y? We can see from the graph that amplitude of X is less compared to amplitude of Y. Or we can say output of Y is more than output of X. Changes which can be made to increase the output are: first, increasing the speed of rotation of the coil. Second, increasing the strength of magnetic field. Third, increasing number of turns on the coil. Now let us have a look at the options given here. A, decrease the magnetic field strength. It's a wrong one. B, increasing the magnetic field strength and decrease the number of coils only. That is also wrong. Option C says increase the number of coils only. So that is also wrong because it's not number of coils, it is number of turns on the coil. Option D, increase the speed of rotation only. So that is a correct option. So answer here is D, increase the speed of rotation only. Question number 35. A transformer is needed to convert a supply of 240 volts AC into 4800 volt AC. Which pair of coils would be suitable for this transformer? We are given a table which gives different options of number of turns on the primary coil NP and number of turns on the secondary coil NS. We know relation between voltage and number of turns, that is V2 by V1 is equals to NS by NP. Let us substitute value of V2 and V1. We have 4800 divided by 240, which on cancellation comes to 20 by 1. So our ratio NS by NP has to be 20:1. That means number of turns on the secondary coil should be 20 times the number of turns on the primary coil. Option C and D are cancelled since they have less number of turns on the secondary coil. Let's now check A and B. NS by NP is equals to 1000 by 50 in A. So that comes to 20:1. So that is the correct option. Let us also check B. 48,000 divided by 240 gives us 200:1. So that's a wrong one. So correct answer here is option A. Primary coil should have 50 turns and secondary coil should have 1000 turns. Question 36. The diagram shows a wire carrying current in the direction shown. There is a magnetic field acting from left to right. The wire experiences a force acting out of the page. The current is now reversed. In which direction does the force on the wire act now? Reversing the current will reverse the direction of force. It was earlier acting out of page. Now on reversing the direction of current, it will act into the page. So option A is the correct answer, into the page. Question 37. Which statement is correct for the nucleus of any atom? Let's have a look at structure of an atom and go on marking whether the statement is correct or wrong. Statement A. The nucleus contains electrons, neutrons and protons. It is a wrong statement. Nucleus contains neutrons and protons only. Electrons are located in the shells around the nucleus. Statement B. Nucleus contains same number of protons as neutrons. Again a wrong statement as number of neutrons is not constant. Statement C. The nucleus has total charge of 0. Again a wrong statement. Nucleus is positively charged due to presence of protons. Protons are neutral and protons are positively charged. So net charge on the nucleus is positive. Statement D. Nucleus is very small compared with the size of an atom. It's a correct statement. Compared to size of atom, size of nucleus is very small. Next question. Question number 38. How many protons and how many neutrons are in a nucleus of 234 90 thorium. Here 90 represents number of protons or atomic number. 234 represents sum of protons and neutrons or mass number. So here if we subtract atomic number from mass number, that is from sum of protons and neutrons, if we remove protons, we have neutrons. So number of neutrons is equals to mass number minus atomic number, that is 234 minus 90, which comes to 144. So now we have number of protons 90, number of neutrons 144. So correct answer is option A, protons 90, neutrons 144. Question 39. Which statement about gamma rays is correct? Let us read the different statements given. A. They are deflected by both electric and magnetic fields. B. They are deflected by magnetic field but not by electric field. C. They are deflected by electric field but not by magnetic field. Option D. They are not deflected either by electric field or by magnetic field. Answer is quite easy one. If you know the properties of gamma rays, you will know the answer. And the answer is option D. They are not deflected either by electric field or by magnetic field. Last question of the paper, question 40. Which equation represents beta decay of lead 209? Let us see what changes are expected during beta decay. A neutron will change to proton, mass number will remain same, atomic number will increase by 1. Since neutron is changing to proton, so atomic number will increase by 1, and a beta particle, which is an electron, is given out. We can straight away cancel option A and B because it's shown that beta particles are being absorbed. Instead of being formed, they are absorbed. Now we will just check option C and D. In C, mass number is same, atomic number is increasing by 1 and 1 beta particle is given out. So option C is a correct answer, but let us check D also. Mass number is same on both sides, but atomic number is decreasing. Instead of increasing, it is decreasing. So even D is wrong. So correct answer is C.